Yay Networks.
13 has been my lucky number for a while. Like, it's always a sign of good things to come for me.
This is 13, a Taylor Swift fan podcast, breaking down every song, every Easter egg, every era, and every theory. Hosted by the biggest Swifties, Nick Adams, Anna Casiejos, Amy Nichols, and Lacey G.
Welcome to 13, a Taylor Swift fan podcast. My name's Nick Adams.
I'm Anna.
Amy.
And I'm Lacey G.
And today we're breaking down The Last Time. This is the 10th track on Red, Taylor's version. It features Gary Lightbody from the band Snow Patrol. And Taylor wrote this song with Gary and Jackknife Lee. Jackknife is a producer who's worked with a lot of artists, very diverse guy. He's worked with U2, The Killers, Snow Patrol, Blur, who we were just talking about.
Oh my God.
Radiohead, Missy Elliott. He's worked with a lot of random people, and he works a lot with Snow Patrol. So Gary brought him along to work with Taylor on this. So it's pretty cool.
I don't know if I've ever said this before, but this is my second favorite track 9.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Track 9.
Mm-hmm.
It's track 10, Lacey.
Come to find out.
Yeah. So this was actually the 7th and final single from the album. If I'm trying to jog my memory back to when this album was first released, mm-hmm. I don't really remember this as being a big promotional single.
I don't either.
And why not? One of the very best collaborations that she's ever done. What?
It is such a beautiful, like, duet. Like, I think their voices really complement each other very well. It's one of those songs that when I'm in the car, I try to sing both parts. And I think it would be a dream to perform this at karaoke. But nobody ever knows, like, other than me, nobody would ever know this song. Unless the four of us go to do karaoke together, yeah. You know? But
we do need to do a Swift Night karaoke.
Tayloroke?
Yes.
Nick, would you do that?
I would.
You do karaoke?
Maybe. We should get a bunch of our listeners together and do
yeah.
it. We should rent out a place.
Oh my God.
And have a Taylor Swift karaoke theme night.
That would be so
and
fun.
And then we can travel around the country
yes.
Love it.
To different spots.
Taylor Oki 13 podcast.
But Yay Networks presents Taylor Oki.
But only in like vacation spots. We want to do it like Adam Sandler.
Yeah. Yeah. We're sorry, Ohio. We're not going to whatever's in Ohio. If there's a good karaoke bar somewhere in Florida, somewhere on a beach in LA, that would
yeah.
be fun.
Somewhere like on a rooftop in New York.
That would be great. That
London?
Would be cool.
London would be great.
I'm in.
Cool, Hawaii.
I just want to know, Anna, I want to hear you performing both parts right now.
Right. This is the last time I'm asking. This is the last time I'm telling you why. Really, especially like at the end of the song where they kind of start to
yeah.
like
when they
sing
go back
over
and
each
back,
other.
Man, every time I try to sing both parts and I confuse myself.
Yeah.
Do y'all try and sing both parts?
Yes.
Or do you
it's
just
impossible.
Try and sing the girl part? Yes.
No, I try to sing both parts. I almost think I can do better with the guy part.
Oh, really?
I don't know.
Because it's a little lower and you can get away with not
yeah.
having the most beautiful voice if it's the dude part.
Yeah, except for like when Taylor goes really low and like All Too Well, 10-minute version, she's like, All Too Well. Like I really feel like, or even like
embarrassed.
At the end of it, yeah. or even like champagne problems.
So if you'd like to come to our karaoke night,
we really sold it.
We're going to, those entrance admissions to our karaoke nights are going to be pretty expensive if we're trying to fly off to New York and other places.
$13 a ticket, obviously.
Wow.
Or $130, but nothing in between.
That'd be great. I know we throw out a lot of ridiculous things, but we should maybe consider that.
13 Taylor Swift podcast,
something
Taylor
like
Oki night. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be fun.
I like it. We'll look into it.
So what's this song about, guys?
Well, we know that it's about a relationship where it's cool when you have songs like this where you do have a female voice and a guy voice. You can kind of get like the two different like perspectives. And Amy, would you say that the last time walked so that exile could run?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. That's a good comparison.
Right? Like
for
I was
sure.
I was reading the comments on the YouTube on the mm-hmm. lyric video, and people were saying that the last time is the exile of the Red era.
Sure.
You know? And I mean when you heard Exile for the first time, like I feel like everybody just got immediate last time mm-hmm. vibes. Yeah.
I've got a little clip here of Taylor talking about the meaning of this song.
I had always wanted to work with Snow Patrol. They're my favorite band. This was a song that I wrote about something I had been going through. I picture like a door,
you know, and you've got on the outside of the door, standing outside in the cold, is this guy who's left his girlfriend over and over again and come back and asked for a second chance. And on the other side of the door, you have this girl standing there with tears in her eyes, wondering how she could possibly turn him away when she loves him this much, but she can't get hurt again. It's both of these people swearing that this will be the last time. She's swearing it's the last time she's going to take him back. He swears it's the last time he's going to leave her and hurt her. So it's a really intense song, and I'm so proud to have Gary on the record.
So I have another quote from Taylor. She pretty much said all the same stuff in this quote, except for this first line. She said, "The idea was based on this experience I had with someone who was kind of this unreliable guy." So I just wanted to say that because I wonder who she's talking about.
Right.
Well, I mean, I guess we could talk about who people think she's talking about. I mean, the only thing that I could find was Jake Gyllenhaal.
Of course.
Yeah. Well, because the secret message in this song is L.A. on break. And, you know, if you kind of look at the timeline, it's possible that Jake was in L.A. promoting Love and Other Drugs whenever it was Taylor's birthday around that time. So that would make sense for L.A. on break. Mm-hmm. And then he keeps coming back and he calls me up and he's like, "I still love you." And I'm like, this is exhausting. Yeah. We are never getting back together.
It is so exhausting whenever you have to go to the back and forth with somebody, and that can really mess with your mental health. And if you need help with that, that's where our friends at BetterHelp come in.
Yeah, what's interfering with your happiness? I know a lot of people still have the hangover from the holidays of dealing with families. Maybe there was something you experienced recently or in the past that you need to get help with. And that's why we recommend BetterHelp. They are going to assess your needs and match you with your own licensed professional therapist, where you can connect in a safe, online, private environment. And it's so convenient, you can start communicating in under 48 hours.
I really liked it because whenever I was looking for a counselor, I was able to sign on and get matched with the counselor immediately, and then they were available to me. I could send them a message at any time, as well as schedule video or phone chats with them. So they made it so easy, and it really helped me whenever I was going through, and still am going through, a lot of things. And I was able to do this in the comfort of my own home, all without having to sit in an uncomfortable waiting room chair.
It really makes it easier when you don't have to drive across town, doesn't it?
It really does. It really does.
So if you need help from a licensed professional counselor who specializes in things like depression, anger, family conflict, self-esteem, grief, anxiety, trauma, even sleeping, BetterHelp is there for you. You can connect in a convenient, professional, and affordable environment, and everything you share is confidential.
I want you to start living a happier life today. As a listener, you'll get 10% off your first month by visiting our sponsor at BetterHelp.com/TaylorSwiftFan. Join over 1 million people who have taken charge of their mental health. Again, that's BetterHelp. HELP.com/TaylorSwiftFan. So if you're wondering why Snow Patrol, why Gary Lighthouse, she told
Lightbody.
Lightbody.
Well, before
did you really say Lighthouse?
Lighthouse?
Did you do that on purpose?
No, with confidence too. I have his name everywhere here, but I wasn't looking at it. Yeah, I said it with confidence.
Yeah.
Before the episode, Anna and I were saying that we keep saying Lightfoot.
Lightfoot. I keep wanting to say Lightfoot.
Gary Lightfoot. That Y'all sounds better than what
Light
is his
body.
Name? Lightbody.
Y'all must not be Snow Patrol fans.
No.
Oh my God, he's so good.
I can't say I'm
great
familiar
in this song.
Yeah.
The Chasing Cars? Is that the Snow Patrol song?
Yes.
I think that's Snow Patrol.
But the big one, I think, well, for our family, the Disney movie Epic, he had his song featured in like that movie.
Okay.
It's called Lightning Strike.
Yeah. Oh, so you're such a big fan because of a Disney movie.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I did see them in concert, Lacey.
Gary Lighthouse?
Yeah. Lightfoot? Lightbody.
Like Snow Patrol was definitely a band that I heard a lot about in like 2008.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like they were real big, kind of not underground, but they were the cool.
It was
cool.
Yeah.
They were really cool to like back then.
Well, Taylor also thinks that they're really cool. She said, Snow Patrol is absolutely dead on. They can just hit you when they're singing about loss or longing. And how they met up actually was through Ed Sheeran. Gary said, Taylor was making her Red album. Her and Ed were recording the song that they did on the record together in Santa Monica, about two blocks away from where I'm standing right now. Ed invited me, with Taylor's permission, to come into the studio and say hi. I'd never met Taylor. She said she was a fan. Apparently, the night before, she and Ed had been playing and singing Set the Fire to the Third Bar. Amy, I'm sure you know that song, together. It was lovely to hear that she knew our music. I can't remember if I was bold enough to ask or if she wanted, or if she asked if she wanted to work with me, but it might as well have been me. He said she was lovely.
Well, and I also like that he said that it was so fast, mm-hmm. that she works really fast. Because I feel like some of the songs that we've heard from Taylor, people that work with Taylor, like Aaron Dessner, when he said that some of the songs from like Folklore she wrote like overnight, mm-hmm. when she was like having a little bit of wine. And yeah. it's like, that turns out to be one of the best songs ever.
mm-hmm.
And then Gary kind of said the same thing. You know, she works really fast. She's extraordinary. He said, we did that song, wrote it, and recorded it in a day. Like, that's crazy.
He said 9 hours.
Yeah.
Wow.
Isn't that incredible?
Yeah.
And he wants to work with her again.
Which he did, technically, when they re-recorded
that's
this.
True. That's true.
You know?
When Red was being re-released, when Taylor re-released it, Snow Patrol posted on their Instagram. They had a long caption, a picture of the album, and they were really praising Taylor. The caption said, it's extraordinary what Taylor is doing with the new versions of her albums, a gargantuan feat that would consume the lives of any mortal musician. However, not only has Taylor Swift been re-recording her previous albums, but also finding the time to somehow record Folklore and Evermore, two of the best albums of the last few years. So they had a lot of good praise for Taylor.
Mm-hmm. Good.
I did see someone say that it's probably, this song is probably the reason why Babe was not on the album.
You think that kicked it off?
Yeah. That was one theory. And then there's another theory. Y'all wait, this is from Lauren Colmier. And she says, Taylor Swift's pizza delivery guy failed to deliver pizza on time. And that's her side. And then the other side, the guy's heartbroken because Swift forgot to tip him.
Oh, my God.
So it's just back and forth, which is ridiculous. But I loved this. I loved it.
That is really funny. I think one of my favorite things about this song, and I didn't even notice this until I saw it, someone pointed it out, but the levels, and it's really, really, really subtle, very subtle, but the levels on the choruses is louder for the person who sang the verse before. So it kind of like gives this like back and forth like experience. So if you listen in the first chorus, it's so Gary sang the first verse. And so then in the first chorus, he's a little bit louder than Taylor. This is the last time I'm asking you this. And then Taylor sings the second verse, so she's a little bit louder in the second chorus. Which I think that it's so subtle,
mm-hmm.
but once you know it, it really does. I mean, the whole song is this like back and forth, different perspective, but even like subtly changing whose voice is louder than the other, like I think is really cool. And then also someone had pointed out that at the beginning of the song, he starts low and she starts high. Open your eyes into mine and everything feels better. And then at the end of the song, she sings low and he goes high. This is the last time I'm asking you less. Time I'm asking you less. So like it's cool because the entire story's a back and forth, the levels are a back and forth, and then even like their notes and like their pitches are back and forth. Like that's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
That's incredible. I'm not a musician, but oh my God.
And I never even picked up on that.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And like how is this not like something we always talk about when we talk about this?
Mm-hmm.
We don't talk about it enough.
So I will say that I do like this version better than the original version. You know, we've talked about before how some songs now that she's older, don't necessarily age as well. Like I think her voice sounds much better being young and innocent sounding on things like 22 and We're Never Getting Back Together. Whereas I think she sounds better on this one because it is a much more mature voice.
Mm-hmm.
The song is very almost like haunting when it starts. It's very like,
yeah,
I don't know if somber is the right word, but it's a little darker. And I just feel like her voice is a little bit more rich. I feel like it more matches his voice because his voice just sounds much older than hers. And I think that gap is not as obvious in the new version, if that makes sense at all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I think I like this version better than the original.
I agree.
Sweet.
The
stolen version.
Right.
I do have a favorite line from the song.
Let's hear it.
And she sings, you find yourself at my door just like those times before. You wear your best apology, but I was there to watch you leave. So it's once again Taylor saying something that we've probably all been through.
Mm-hmm.
We've all had those relationships where it is a back and forth. You break up, you get back together, and you know it's not going anywhere. And someone has to put their foot down.
Mm-hmm.
And in this case, it's probably her. And I just really like being able to put my experiences into this song. And I think that's probably one of the reasons why her music captivates so many people because it can be so relatable.
Yeah. I think I agree with you. And I think one of the most heartbreaking parts is where she says, like, this is the last time I'm asking you this. Put my name at the top of your list.
Mm-hmm.
Like, make me a priority.
Yeah.
You know, like, this is the last time I'm asking you to, like, put me first.
Mm-hmm.
And I just think that's incredibly heartbreaking.
Similar to the tolerate it.
It is.
Yeah. Idea. Exactly.
Yeah.
This is the last time I'm asking you why you break my heart in the blink of an eye. That's just so heartbreaking. And all the times I let you in just for you to go again. Disappear when you come back. Everything is better.
By your eyes, I'm breaking.
You can hear more of this goodness
at our Tayloroke.
Dates to be determined. Someone else on Reddit said the most magical moment was when she played it during her 1989 tour with Wildest Dreams. Probably my favorite concert moment ever. I think they wrote this before they listened to Lacey and Nick's concert, because then that would have been the best concert moment
for
ever.
Sure.
But I was trying to find it, but I couldn't find a version of that on YouTube.
Can all of our karaoke nights be on the 13th?
Yes.
Although we do wake up really early, so maybe that's not a great
idea.
Well,
we'll pick out all the 13s that are Saturdays.
Okay. That's a way better
maybe
idea.
Maybe like twice a year, right?
Yeah.
Maybe
that's how often?
I don't know. That's a guesstimate.
How often does the 13th? Because this upcoming, like in February, the 13th is Sunday. So, sucks. We'll have to try the next
the Super
one.
Bowl. Let's do a karaoke night. All of Taylor Swift's fans can come out to a karaoke night while
all
their husbands.
Great turnout.
We probably
would have a great, yeah. Yeah.
But
husbands
not
would probably buy the tickets for their wives to get them out the door.
My boyfriend wouldn't even know I'm gone.
Can I change the subject real fast?
Mm-hmm.
Is anyone still keeping up with their New Year's resolution?
I'm trying, but it's so hard. I am worried about the things that I am and am not receiving in my diet.
Well, did you know that 97% of women aged 19 to 50 are not getting enough vitamin D from their diet, and 95% are not getting their recommended intake of key omega-3s? That's why we want to suggest to you our friends at Ritual.
Well, Nick, I hate to be a bragger, but I am not one of those, because I have started taking my Ritual Essential for Women 18 plus, which I'm barely older, but come on, I can get that, the multivitamin, and it was formulated by exhaustive research to help fill nutrient gaps in the diets of women ages 18 plus. It is formulated with nutrients to help support brain health, bone health, blood health, and provide antioxidant support. So I feel like I'm living my healthiest life.
And Ritual doesn't stop there. They invested in a gold standard university-led clinical trial to prove the impact of Essential for Women 18 Plus vitamin. And the results, they are there. Essential for Women 18 Plus was shown to increase vitamin D levels by 43% and omega-3 DHA levels by 41% in 12 weeks. And guess what, fellas? If there are any guys listening to this, they do have an option for men that I've been taking for quite a while, and I absolutely love it. Right now, Ritual is offering our listeners 10% off your first 3 months. Visit ritual.com/TaylorSwiftFan and turn healthy habits into a ritual. That's 10% off at ritual.com/TaylorSwiftFan.
Hey guys, before we go, we got an email here from Danny. You can always send us an email. Our email and social media are all in the description of the podcast below. So this is from Danny. She says, "Hello Swifties, I discovered your podcast in September and I've been obsessed ever since. I love how there's always more to learn about Taylor and her genius. Anyways, I'm from Pennsylvania. I'm sure other people may have reached out to you, but I would like to help you out with pronunciation."
Oh Lord.
Oh no.
"Of the towns that Taylor is from."
Okay.
I thought she would just meant in general. Yeah, I was like, how long is this email?
Yeah. No.
Era.
So there's a town called Wyomissing. Wyomissing. She says it's pronounced Y-O-Miss-ing. So it's kind of Wyomissing.
Wyomissing.
I don't know where the emphasis goes, but why Wyomissing?
Okay.
But anyways, the biggest one here is when we were pronouncing one of the towns she's from, is it Reading? Is it Reading, Pennsylvania?
Yeah, I remember
we're not
this.
Sure. And she says it's pronounced Reading. Red like the color.
Okay.
But it's written Reading.
R-E-A-D-I-N-G.
But it's pronounced Reading.
Reading.
The most confusing place I've ever lived in was Georgia, because I was born in Texas, and then I moved to Georgia whenever I was young. Well, I moved to Houston County. And, of course, Texas, we're used to Houston, and like, why? But it was named after a person. So there was at least a reason for it. But it was so confusing. Yeah. Does anybody know the capital of Pennsylvania?
Is it Reading?
I don't know.
Is it a mountain?
I don't know.
Man. Well, you're asking us, but you don't know that.
No, I don't know.
Pennsylvania. What's the capital of Pennsylvania?
I have like zero Pennsylvania facts.
Google it, Anna.
Pennsylvania. Hold on. Pennsylvania. Capital.
I do have a Pennsylvania fact.
Harrisburg.
We all knew Harrisburg. Yeah. That was the next thing.
Yeah.
And before you end the episode, mm-hmm. Nick, I just can't let it end without saying I have beef with Rolling Stones.
Oh, good.
Because they said, and out of all 206 Taylor Swift songs, that this song was 197.
I'm sorry.
Oh, wow, that's pretty low.
Wait, really?
Yes. I mean, you're shocked too?
Yeah, I am shocked.
Okay, where did they rank me?
Oh, I don't know.
Okay.
And what did they rank?
They're not reliable.
And what did they rank last?
I didn't. You guys, I only have this.
She only has this one stat.
Did they rank All Too Well as number 3?
Great comeback. Great. I'll stop talking now.
No, I'm curious.
My Pennsylvania fact, by the way, is that Danny lives there and it's pronounced Redding. Those are my Pennsylvania facts.
The last song on their ranking is Bad Blood.
Well,
that's rude.
I mean,
that's rude.
I can think of a few that are better than Bad Blood.
Well, why is Bad Blood below Santa Baby?
Hey, so you're talking about Houston and Houston, Lacey. Do mm-hmm. you know what Soho means? Like when you're in New York? Soho? It's like a neighborhood, an area of Soho?
I used to know this, but I have forgotten. No.
It's south of Houston. It's pronounced, it's spelled Houston.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're not from New York, people are like, where's Houston? They're like, no, it's Houston. Mm. So it's just like how they pronounce it in Georgia.
Yeah. Wrong.
Well, that does it for us here at 13, a Taylor Swift fan podcast. What did we miss? I'm sure we missed something. Please let us know. All the ways to contact us are in the description of this podcast. Please go ahead and subscribe to us wherever you're listening to us on right now and leave us a good review. And join us next week because we're going to be breaking down her song, Holy Ground.
Thanks for listening to 13, a Taylor Swift fan podcast. Subscribe for free and leave a positive review on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or Google Podcasts.